There are new details about why Metro Police believe a man gunned down his wife, then turned the weapon on himself. It happened early this morning on Weatherby Avenue in Middletown. WLKY's Marissa Alter is live outside of police headquarters with the latest developments. Marissa?
Rick, it was just 2 weeks ago that 38-year-old Karen Carr requested an emergency protective order against her estranged husband. 44-year-old James Johnson Carr moved out as a result of that, but police say he returned early this morning around 2:15, shot her, then himself, all while their little girl was asleep in another room.
It was pretty heartbreaking this morning. I had some tears.
It's horrible. I mean, what do? You don't expect that.
Neighbors awake to find their sleepy Middletown street swarming with police. Two residents dead, their home a crime scene.
It appears at this point in the investigation that Mr. Carr had shot his wife, which we would deem at this point a murder-suicide.
A frantic early morning phone call from James Johnson Carr's family alerted police to trouble at this house.
We believe that, that Mr. Carr was on the phone kind of describing what was taking place, his mental state, which obviously alerted family members who contacted police at that point and obviously contacted 911.
It wasn't the first run police made to this address. According to an arrest report, on April 16th, Karen Carr called 911 after she says her husband held her arms and put a knife to her throat. Following that incident, a judge granted her a domestic violence order and Johnson Carr left. Today, that all changed.
We believe early this morning that the husband did actually use a pry bar or some type of tool to force his way into the home.
Also there at the time, the couple's 18-month-old daughter. Police discovered her in her crib unharmed when they arrived, now without a father or a mother who police say tried to protect her.
Obviously very tragic. She's trying to do the right thing and do what she's supposed to do. She took the order out as she was supposed to, and obviously a judge granted a domestic violence order. You have to realize, though, that is only a piece of paper.
Now, that little girl is now staying with her grandmother. Neighbors tell us that the couple kept to themselves, and they were not aware of any problems between the two. Coming up tonight at 11, we'll take a closer look at the Carr's violent and troubled history. Reporting live outside police headquarters, Marissa Alter, WLKY News.